The El Nino weather phenomenon has so far affected more than 100 local government units. According to Task Force El Nino, about 131 cities and municipalities nationwide have declared a state of calamity. Task Force spokesperson Assistant Secretary Joey Villarama says damage to agriculture has reached 4.39 billion pesos, covering more than 77,000 hectares of land. Villarama, however, says it's not a total loss. Meantime, State Weather Bureau Pagasa warns of even hotter temperatures on the first half of May, even though the El Niño phenomenon is getting weaker.
The U.S. military's estimated cost to build a pier off Gaza to deliver humanitarian aid has risen to $320 million. A Reuters source says that's roughly double the initial estimate earlier this year. Lawmakers have questioned whether the pier is a worthwhile endeavor, particularly given the risk the U.S. military personnel could become targets of Hamas militants. President Joe Biden announced the construction of the pier in March as aid officials implored Israel to ease access for relief supplies.
Columbia University begins suspending pro-Palestinian activists who have defied a deadline to dismantle dozens of tents on the New York campus. The university sent protesters a letter earlier Monday warning students who did not vacate the encampment and sign a form acknowledging their participation would face suspension and become ineligible to complete the semester. Protesters have vowed to stay until Columbia meets three demands: the divestment of assets that support Israel's military, transparency in finances, and amnesty for students and faculty who took part in the protests. In the U.S., four police officers are killed and four others are wounded in a shooting in Charlotte, North Carolina. The local police chief said the officers were killed while attempting to serve a warrant for possession of a firearm to a convicted felon in his home. The suspect was also killed in the gunfire. Two others were arrested.
The Philippine military, meanwhile, says it is monitoring three Chinese research vessels in Ayungin Shoal. A Navy spokesperson said Tuesday the vessels are carrying unidentified equipment, supposedly for research activities. The armed forces earlier today confirmed a Chinese vessel roaming the country's eastern seaboard. The survey vessel, named Shen Kuo, is said to have ignored radio challenges by Philippine authorities after loitering off Catunduanes over the weekend. The Navy suspects the timing of the vessel's deployment is deliberate amid the ongoing war games between the Philippines and the U.S.
It is their way of showing that they are not deterred, they are not scared by what is happening in the West Philippine Sea. Sinabay nila sa paggawa natin ng bigay. When you don't respect international law, your actions will change. Your behavior will be erratic. If you respect international law, your actions will be consistent.
Philippine Marines secure an area in the province of Palawan ahead of drills as part of the Balakatan exercises later this week. Two companies from the Marines swept a village facing the West Philippine Sea. They checked and cleared the area where U.S. troops are set to mount a high-mobility artillery rocket system for a fresh round of live-fire exercises. The troops also completed amphibious exercises after jumping off a landing craft unit from a warship.